My name is Mr. Ishengoma. Today, we are going to introduce bounds. When we are talking about bounds, basically, we are looking at limits. Usually, we have what we call the upper limit of a number, and also we have the lower limit of a number. For example, if I have a number 32, a number 32, to be 32, it has got some limits. When I want to round it off to 32, the only possible numbers that can round off to 32 could be 31.5, because if I round off 31.5, this will become 32. And another one could be 32.4, because if I round off 32.4, this one will remain 32. But in between there, we have got so many numbers. Now, what do we mean by limit? Limit is the smallest possible number that can round off to the number we want, and the biggest possible number that can round off to the number we want. For the case of 32, 32.4 is not the biggest number, because we can still have other decimal 9999999, which are continuing to recur. So when we talk about the upper limit, we are talking about the biggest possible number that can round off to the given current number. And when you're talking about the lower limit, we are talking about the smallest possible number that can round off to the current number. Now, the upper limit is what we call the upper bound. And the lower limit is what we call the lower bound. When you look at our chosen example, you will clearly see the lower bound is very clear. According to example, it will be 31.5. That's clear, that's the lowest. But when you look at the upper bound is not clear. Why? Because it is 32.4, but there are so many nines which are possible. Why? Because when we are rounding off to 32, we will mainly consider just the next number. So once the next number is 4, meaning it will remain 32. And once the next number is 5 or more, it will take us to the next day, to the next number, and that is 32. Now, remember, when I have got so many nines and you try to approximate, if I have 32.499999, if you approximate it, it will still take you to 32.5. But remember, 32.5, when you want to round it off, it will take you to 33. And we don't need 33. Because we don't need 33, and we know if we round it off to this, it will give us 33. Therefore, we shall have a statement like this. The number which I have, that is my 32, 31.5 is smaller than my 32, but when I round it off, it will take me to 32. But when I take 32.5, yes, X, which is 32, is smaller than 32.5, and they will never be equal, because if you check closely, if I round off this, it will take me to 32. But if I round off this, it will take me to 33. But I need a 32. Hence, when we want to use 32.5, then we shall always indicate that it will never be equal to the current number. But For the lower limit, it is always equal. Now, to make all this easy, we ignore the numbers and we use the rounded off. So this takes us to understanding another concept when you look at bounds. This means when we are looking at the bounds, that is the lower bound and the upper bound, we shall take a gap of 1 unit. For instance, if I have 1 centimeter, this one I have to split into 2 to get 0.5. Then for the case of lower bound, I will subtract 0.5. And for the case of upper bound, I will add 0.5. And if I have, let's say, 0.1, then I will take 0.1, I'll divide by 2, I get 0.05. Then for the case of lower bound, I will subtract 0.05. And for the case of upper bound, I will add 0.05. Now let's use the 32 example we had. Let's use the 32 as our main example for this explanation. Given 32 to nearest ones. This is the most important concept, nearest ones. If it is nearest ones, that means I take 1. When I divide by 2, I get 0.5. So for the lower bound, I'll take 32 minus 0.5. And for the upper bound, I'll take 32 plus 0.5. When I subtract, I get 31.5. And there I get 32.5. Therefore, for the case of our number 32, 31.5 is smaller than 32, but once you round it off, they'll become equal. But 32.5 is bigger than 32, meaning 32 will be smaller. But when you round it off, this will go to 33. They'll never be equal. Hence, when we want to find upper bound and lower bound, we will use these kinds of inequalities to represent the reality. And what is our reality? Our reality says the lower bound will always round off to the given number, but the upper bound will always not round off to a given number. Hence, since the lower bound will round off to the given number, we keep the equal sign, and the upper bound will always never round to the given number, we don't keep the equal sign. Let's see more examples under this. There we go. Find the bounds. Now here we need to find the bounds. So we read the question number 1. The length of a rod is 34 kilometers to nearest kilometer. So when we say nearest kilometer is the same as saying nearest ones, is the same as saying nearest ones. So if it is nearest ones, we take 1, right? This 1, we divide it by 2 and we get 0.5. After getting this, now 0.5 will go for lower bound and another 0.5 will go for upper bound. So for lower bound, it will be 24 minus 0.5. But for upper bound, it will be 24 plus 0.5. Hence, we shall get 23.5 for the lower bound and 24.5 for lower bound. But remember, we know this upper bound will never be equal. So we shall state it like 23.5 is smaller than or equal to our given length. But our given length will always be smaller than 24.5 because we know 24.5 we round off to the next number. So this will act as our lower bound, and this will act as our upper bound. Let's look to example two. The height of John is 190 centimeters to nearest tens. So if it is nearest tens, we shall take 10. This 10, we shall divide it by 2, and we get 5. Okay, so if I need lower bound, then I will take 190 and I subtract 5. And if I need upper bound, I will take 190 and I will plus 5. When I subtract 5, I get 185. And when I add 5, I'll get 195. As usual, we know 195 will not round off back to 190. So in our statement of the answer, we shall say 185 is smaller or equal to the height of John, but this height of John is always smaller to 195. That's how we keep our final statement. Let's look at example number three. The depth of a pit is 3.45 meters to the nearest two decimal places. Two decimal places. This is the key point. Two decimal places. So since we're using a unit of one, all the time we're using a unit of one. So we shall say two decimal places can be represented by 0.1. Remember, it must always be unit of one. Even here, previous question, it was 10, we used 10. Even here, it was to nearest kilometer, we used one. Always we use unit of one. So when we divide by 2, we shall get 0.005. So 0.005 will go for lower bound, and another 0.005 will go for upper bound. This means my lower bound will be 3.45 minus 0.005, and my upper bound will be 3.45 plus 0.05. Here we shall get 3.445. And down we shall get 3.455. Hence, we know the upper bound won't round off to the given number. So if it won't round off, so we shall state 3.445 is small or equal to our depth, but our depth is smaller than 3.455 because you never know. Let's look at our last example of how we find upper bound and lower bound. The length of a car is 4.2 meters to the nearest 10. This is our key point, 10th. And we know 10th is just after a decimal point. So a 10th is like 0.1. Remember, we always use a unit of 0.1 to split. So 0.1 to represent 10th. So I divide it by 2, I get 0.05. Remember, 0.05 will go for the lower bound, and another 0.05 will go for upper bound since we split it by 2. So in order to get my lower bound, then I'll take 4.2 and I'll subtract 0.05. At the same time, to get the upper bound, I'll take 4.2 and I will plus 0.05. So when I subtract, I'll get 4.15. And when I add, I'll get 4.25. And that is my lower bound and upper bound. But to put in a proper statement, I'll write 4.15 as my lower bound, which will be smaller or equal to my length of the car. But my length of the car will always be smaller than 4.25. We say it will always be smaller because if I round this off back, this will give me 4.3, and 4.3 is not our actual length. So we don't keep equal sign on the side of the upper bound. This is how we simply find lower bound and upper bound of a number. My name is Mr. Ishengoma. Thank you for watching. However, for more videos, please subscribe to my channel.